Hi guys, it's Anna from Vectornator. Welcome to another Academy video. As you can see from the title, we are learning clipping masks today. First of all, in order to apply a mask, you need two objects. One I already have. It's the zebra pattern here, which I created by drawing all these shapes individually and then grouping them together into one. So let's create our second object in order to apply our mask. I will simply draw a rectangle with the shape tool. Let's say we're designing a card, and I'm going to pick a different color for the rectangle to make my graphic more interesting. In order to see the final design of your card, you can lower the opacity of the rectangle on top and move it around until you are happy with the resulting pattern. But there's a second way to do it, which I'll show after applying the mask. So I'll turn the opacity back up for now. If we need two objects to do this operation, then naturally, I select both, and then I tap on the mask button here in the quick actions menu. And voila! The clipping mask was applied according to the shape on top. Be mindful of this behavior, as the object on top dictates not only the shape, but also other properties, like, say, opacity. And if you want to change the pattern that is under the mask, simply double tap the masked object to activate isolation mode. Now you can move the mask around or make it smaller, give it an entirely different shape, whatever you need to create your design. At this stage, I can still change the color of my mask, so I think I'll just apply a quick gradient. Okay, I am happy with the design, so I'll exit isolation mode by simply double tapping again. And here's the final result. This was our quick and easy tour on clipping masks. Personally, I think masking is really cool with patterns or textures, but the sky's the limit, so have fun with it. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in our next video.